Lord, we should not be seen getting wrapped in the darkness of error, but seen standing in the brightness of light of the truth. Yes. Iroju, today's first reading is taken from the book of Genesis, chapter 18. Here we find the, if you see the friend before that, if you see the beginning of chapter of 18, we find the gloomy face of Sarah and the bright face of Abraham. They have no children. She is hiding in the tent, and the angels who came, three people, they were just passing by. What is the atmosphere? Atmosphere is very hot. It is written there. It was very hot. So they could not stay inside the tent. They were just sitting, just entrance. They let there may be little breeze. They cannot come out. Outside it is very hot. Inside very hot. It's the only place they can just get a little breathing. You know, that is the pressure. So when we get irritated, when we get very hot, we don't feel like even meeting anybody. That is the time three people are coming. Immediately, Abraham, he sees somebody who are walking in the hot sun. They need a little generosity to wash their feet, because it is full of dust, sandy land, and need something to drink or eat, because in the heat, whatever you eat will get digested. You will feel hungry very fast. Here is a man who feels the need of another. That is called divinity. Divinity is more than humanity. That is to see God in another. God's see God in another. If we have this nature, God will always do what is best for us. And the very nature will lead us to God. That's why the Bible says, don't get wrapped in the darkness of the error, but stand in the brightness of the light of truth. Yes, if you want to see problem, you will have plenty. If you want to see the light, it is available for you. The way you look, you become. The way you think, you become. Unless you transform your thinking, unless you sharpen your thinking, unless you focus on who your God is and making yourself with that, you achieve nothing. And Abraham, seeing somebody in trouble, he never saw, oh, inside is very hot, outside is very hot. No, when he saw somebody in problem, he saw, what I can do. He saw God in himself. When you see God in yourself, God will see you as his friend. That's why in chapter 18, verse 17, the Lord says, can I hide anything, what I am going to do, from my friend Abraham? God wants each one of us to be his friends. That's what he said in John chapter 15, verse 15, 14 onwards. I don't call you servants, because I call you my friends, because all that my Father teaches me, I reveal to you. So God saw Abraham as his friend. What is there for him to find as a friend? Because he sees God in others. Yeah, see and serve God in the human face. We have to see God in human face and serve God in the human face. That is the theme of Divine Life Society. Abraham, when he began to see God in the others, he goes to the cattle field, brings one sheep, kills it, and tells Sarah, "You are also getting inside. Come on, work to do something. When you do something good for others, you get new energy. You get new life. I want to give something for others." So they are preparing. They are preparing. And seeing this, the Lord's angel says, when you try to do good for those who are in need, the curses are, the blessings that are blocked will get opened for you. So he says, they ate nicely. After eating, they are saying, next year, by this time, Sarah will have a child. Sarah says, I am old. Now everything is gone. I am almost reaching 99. In this age, what? She was laughing to herself. So, anything somebody says, you don't get offended with that. You make it as a laughter. Even in that, she may not accept a certain thing. Take it with a smile. Take it with laughter. Is something great. And of course, they said, why are you laughing? No, I didn't laugh. She tries to manage. They said, no, you laughed, but your goodness God has noticed, and God will pay you back. When the goodness of God was revealed to Abraham, the angels are, those three men are saying, they did not reveal as angels. They said, we are going to Sodom. You know why? Because the sin is so much. And we are going to see the complainers come. And we are going to see whether is it true. God has not gone to destroy it. God sent his angels to see that. And immediately Abraham realizes, oh, there, my brother's son who cheated me, who took away the best land from me, and he built his big mansion. He never called me one day. Uncle, because of you, we have a big house. Come one day for a dinner. Abraham doesn't know where Lot is staying. He only knows that in Sodom he is staying. Once you get into the world, worldly riches, you will not remember goodness. The richness of the world can easily take you away from God and make you to get satisfied with what you have. But having received goodness from God and having been called by God as a friend, the heart of Abraham moves. As God has shown him goodness, he shows goodness. He tells, if there are 50 people, will you save that city? Then he comes little 5. He says, Lord, if there is 45, still he is moving with that 5 only, will it be 40? The Lord is not getting angry. The goodness of the Lord, he says, now he dares, not 5. Now he says 10, from 30, 40 to 30, he says, if there are 30 people. From 30 he comes to 20. From 20 he comes to 10. When you see the goodness of God, you move in the goodness of God. The Lord says, even if there are 10 people in that city, good people, I will never destroy. I am a God of goodness. I am God of love. Yes. The man who cheated him, Abraham, showed goodness. And that's why when Abraham was in trouble, God saved him. God, without knowing, Abraham told his wife Sarah, tell that you are my sister. And Abimelech wanted to take that wife of Abraham. God said to Abimelech in the dream, don't touch Sarah. She's the wife of my prophet. First time the word prophet is given for Abraham from the mouth of God. Prophet is one who takes the people's prayer to God and bring God's answer to the people.